CNN has obtained an exclusive video from a journalist who spent time with rebel units in Aleppo and brought back some startling footage.
Here in Aleppo, the fight is mostly Syrian to Syrian, street to street. But on the radio is Firas, a foreign fighter. He is Libyan. He says he braved the regime's tank shells because his fight for Libya compelled him to also fight here.
We live this moment, you know. We feel this moment. So, you know, as it was in Libya. We cannot say this is not freedom fighters. They protested to get free the government around the world. I don't know why they only watch. You know, they don't give support. They don't give us no fly zone.
Libya got NATO's help. Syria, for now, gets his.
It looks like the devil, you know? He likes to speak, likes not speak, he likes to bark, you know, barking, you know? For one, 2 hours, you know? Never stop lying.
The Syrian regime blames foreign radicals for the uprising, trying to conjure up fears of a takeover by Islamist extremists. While Firas embraces religion, he dismisses extremism and al-Qaeda altogether.
I'm only a student. I left my money, my student, my family. We're not al-Qaeda. We're not coming to break this country. We came here to help.
There could be thousands of foreign fighters in Syria, some radical, some not. While rebels may want battle-hardened fighters here now, they may regret that when the extremists decide to stay, says one expert.
I think they don't have any benefit in having them. But I think at this point, because of their weaker weaponry and training and ability, they may need them to fight. If you assume the fighting is going to be finished, I think they are there to stay. And what we might witness is something like Yemen, where the foreign fighters will be able to control certain areas or cities.
Firas does say he wants an Islamic government for Syria, but he wants to go back home. That's where he learned about loss. He still wears the shirt of his brother, who died fighting in Libya. And in Syria, he's already lost a Libyan friend to a sniper's bullet.
And the sniper was shooting one here, and the second one's here, which is this one, and the third in the stomach, so you can't see this.
In the brutal Syrian battle for every corner, the foreigners here and the concerns they bring of radicalism might be attracting more attention than their numbers merit. But the UN believes their influence is growing and that some of it is radical. And that, as this war drags on, may well grow. Nick Paton Walsh, CNN, Beirut.